types of supports and corresponding reactions at the supports. For example, AB is the beam and at A and B it is simply supported. There is no fixity, so therefore it is called as a simply supported beams. Now the loads may be point load or uniform distributed load or uniform varying load or any type of load that may be combined. Now RA and RB are the reactions at corresponding supports. So now as these loads are acting in the vertical downward direction, so that means vertically downward, so therefore the reactions will be vertically upward. That means now corresponding reactions are vertically upward. The second type of the support is the hinged support. That means now at this point it is also called as a pin support. So now at this position the beam can rotate in the vertical plane only, it cannot move in the horizontal direction. So that means now if the load is vertical, there will be a vertical component. If it is a load is inclined, then it has to resolve into two components, that is, for example, W Newton is the weight. So then corresponding this component is W cos theta and W sin theta. In order to balance the W cos theta, so there should be a reaction developed at this hinge, that is represented by RAH. And then for this vertical load, the RAV is the, that means there are two reactions which are developed at the hinge depending upon loading condition. The another condition is that this case will exist again. Suppose there may not be a load inclined or vertical, all loads may be vertical loads. So that means vertical loads, or it may be a combination of loads. Though the loads are vertically downward, but because of the other end is inclined, so the reaction RB will be inclined, so like this. Therefore, the resolved component of this RB is along x-axis, it will be RB cos theta, and along y-axis RB sin theta. In order to balance the RB cos theta, now there should be a reaction developed opposite to that one, RAH, and that means horizontal component of the reaction at H, A, and then for in order to balance this RB sin theta, there will be a vertical reaction in addition to these, the downward loads, so it has to balance that. So RAV is the vertical reaction. So that means the loads may be inclined, or even the loads may be the downward, acting downward, but because of the other end, the inclined, so there will be a horizontal component that has to be developed at the hinge. That is what we said, that the hinge support, we have the two reactions. One is the horizontal corresponding to the horizontal forces, and there will be vertical component corresponding to the vertical loads. So other type of support is the roller support. So wherein you will find that at the roller support, this is a roller support because now it has got the chance of horizontal movement. So therefore only one reaction will develop. This reaction will be always normal to the surface of the roller. That means now this roller is horizontal here, so therefore perpendicular that one is the vertical RB. Whereas in this case, if you see it, the rollers are inclined by a certain angle, then this reaction will be always normal to the surface. So that means this angle will have to calculate corresponding this. So that means in this triangle, so 180 minus this alpha minus 90, that is your theta value, you will get it. Now this is the, that means now the always this support reaction is normal to the surface of the roller. Here it is horizontal, so therefore it's vertical. Here it is inclined, so therefore the RB is inclined. Only one reaction will develop at the roller support. So far we have discussed about the types of loads and then the where they are going to be concentrated. Next is the supports, the types of supports, and then corresponding reactions where they will be developed. So in case of the simply supported the beams, the reactions will be vertical, and at the hinge you will be two, the components will get it, and at the roller support always only one reaction will be there, that will be normal to the surface of the roller. So now start with the numericals on this chapter.